Thorpe Road Sluice is at the northern end of Aldeburgh, and before fishing it, I decided to have a look at the Aldeburgh Blind match, which is being fished here. The match was held in mid-October across three zones, and the winner, Cameron Turner from Felixstowe, was here at this zone, zone one. Cameron had a late caught bass to go with his 10 other sizeable fish. Third in the match was also in this zone, to the left of his outlet pipe, closer to Thorpe Ness itself. In all, there were 109 sizeable fish caught here, the vast majority obviously being whiting, 95 of them. That doesn't tell the whole story though, since some anglers were catching 20 or 30 fish, with none of them big enough to count. However, some anglers were lucky enough to weigh in fish other than whiting, and there were 6 dabs, 3 bass, 1 dogfish, 3 eels, and 1 sole also caught here. My first outing was a month later, and I'd be fishing it over low water, and I chose to fish to the left of the outlet. The match was fished with a tide coming up, so I wasn't sure if it was going to be any good or not. And of course, by fishing later in the year, I was expecting to catch more whiting than there were in that match. As I was setting up, the angler to my left was already putting in whiting, so my task was to catch anything other than whiting. The long snood flapper rig would be used to target bass close in. However, I've only got lugworm with me today. The rigs I've chosen for mid to distance work are to keep the bait close to the seabed, hopefully targeting flatfish. I wouldn't be using these if I was trying to catch sizeable whiting, and if I was expecting codling, I'd be using up and over rigs or pulley panels. As I'm about to cast my second rig out, I'll run for locational details. Aldeburgh is in Suffolk, with some well-known venues which are adjacent to those of Orford Ness. Zooming in, the Martello Tower is at the southern end, just past the town zone. The crag path is at the seaward end of most of the built-up area. The scallop structure is just out of the town, and the Thorpe Road Sluice is between that and the marks at Thorpe Ness. The outlet pipe is a notable feature, and there's some off-road parking nearby. I've identified the location of the two marks I've fished for this video. I've set up on the shingle slope, and I'm keeping my rods fairly low. I'm hoping that this might help when it comes to trying to catch flatfish. The tidal pool is not strong enough to warrant using leads with wires, so it's quite easy to drag your baits. I'm getting little pulls on the rod tips right from the off. Although sometimes it's difficult to tell, these don't look like flatfish bites to me. I strike the left rod and I'm in straight away. As I thought, the culprits are the dreaded whiting. I don't mind catching them if there's nothing much about, but my target for today is to catch anything other than these whiting. first fish on a boom rig, and again, it's a whiting. There's no point casting the rig to the same place, so this time I'm dropping it a bit short. Another double shot on the so-called sole rig. I'm still fishing this rig at distance, so I'm clipping down before casting. Although the booms don't seem to be putting the whiting off, I'm not getting so many fish on this rig. Hopefully that will allow something else to get a look in. There's no shortage of action, and you don't have to wait long for bites. Fortunately, they're all from whiting. And there's the first triple shot on a boom rig. Having already lost count of another whiting I've had, 20 odd I would imagine, it's time for a change. Might seem daft, but I decided to give the float a go. You never know, that could pick up a bass, but I'd be happier using ragworm rather than lugworm for this method. Conditions looked good for it though. On my other rod, I'm now fishing that long snood flapper rig close in, and there's the first bite I've had on it. I thought I had a fish on, but unfortunately there's nothing there. No signs on the float yet. There's the first fish on the flapper rig, and unfortunately it is another whiting. Give up on the float, and I'm back to fishing both rods on the bottom, fairly close in. Even at 5 yards out, I'm still picking up whiting. Plenty of fish, but I regarded this session as a bit of a failure. My target was to catch anything other than whiting, and although I caught some which would have been in size for that match, still a bit disappointed. I would have settled for anything other than whiting, but I did end up with 40 plus. Had I been fishing for whiting all out, that would have been doubled probably. A week later I was back, but this time to fish over high water. I brought a greater variety of baits with me this time, including sticky black lug, ragworm, squid, sprats, as well as dungy blacks, which I had last time. My boom rigs will be fished with ragworm and sticky black lug tipped with sprats. I'll be trying whole squid for something bigger, although it's doubtful if I'll catch a codling. The sticky black lug and small sections of sprat are my preferred bait for targeting dabs. As well as dungy blacks, I've also got fresh blow lug. And to complete the bait list, there's ragworm of various sizes. Hopefully, with a wider choice of baits, I might catch something other than whiting. As soon as I cast the boom rig out, I get a bite straight away. Yes, you've guessed it, it's a whiting. For my second rod, I'm starting with a whole squid on an up and over rig. This rig utilises the Trident components. I've forgotten my sunglasses, so I'm having to use a cap with a visor. Unlike last time, it didn't take long to get triple shot on a boom rig. Casting the boom rig about 30 to 40 yards out, hoping that that might be where the dabs are. No dabs there, but plenty of whiting. Last time, hardly any of my fish were deeply hurt, but this one needs disgorging. Since I'm not here to catch whiting, it's time to swap that boom rig over to the long snood flapper rig. There's possibly a better chance of catching bass at the top of tide rather than at low tide when I fished it last time. And this time I've got ragworm with me, which I think is a better choice of bait. My flapper rig has got size 10 hooks, which is okay for bigger sized ragworm. I'll start with a 10-yard cast and then possibly try a little bit closer in. Looks like my first bite was missed. A fish and a whole squid, which I think might have been on for quite some time. It's still a whiting, but one of fairly decent size. Trying double lugworm and squid this time. Well, would you believe it, this is not a whiting. The ragworms caught me a bass, but it's not quite the size I wanted. That felt like a decent fish, but it's come off on the way in. I don't think it was a whiting, unless it was foul hurt. Possibly a dogfish. I'm hoping it wasn't the lost codling. I've now started baiting up a short wire boom rig. I'm hoping that this might work for dabs if a long boom rig doesn't. The baiting up process is interrupted as I spot another bite. It's a triple shot on a long snood rig which was just cast about 10 yards out, and it looks like there's something different on a middle snood. A whiting falls off the top snood, but there's a pouting on the middle one. Okay, well it's not something I'm overjoyed about, but at least it's not a whiting, so I should really count this trip as being more successful than the previous one. High tide's come and gone without any other different fish making an appearance, and it's time to start moving down the beach. Whiting are still coming in though, and that's another one on a whole squid. Time to have a look at the rigs I'm using now that the tide is ebbing. I think there's less chance of a bass now, so I won't be using that long snood flapper. The boom rigs are my best bet for a flatfish. Plenty of bites, whichever boom rig I'm using, but still only whiting. And there's another triple shot. There's a lot more whiting coming out now that it's ebbing, and I'm also getting a regularly on the up and over rig with a whole squid. I fished on until the light started to fade, swapping rigs round, but, unfortunately, the whiting were just relentless. Another busy session, fewer whiting than before, but that's mainly because I was fishing with one rod having big baits on. I ended up with 30 plus whiting, that pouting and that tiny little bass. It was a bit disappointing that dabs didn't show, and the sole would have been a bit of a long shot, although there was one caught here during that match. I think I'll leave fishing this end of Aldeburgh for the summer.